Hi, this is the House of Sacred Noise. I'm Cloudless Rain, and today we're going to read Pete the Cat. But first, a little bit of music. Litwin and James Dean. Pete the Cat was walking down the street in his brand new white shoes. Pete loved his white shoes so much that he sang this song. I love my white shoes. 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 Oh no! Pete stepped in a large pile of strawberries. What color did they turn his shoes? Red! Did Pete cry? Goodness, no. He kept walking along and singing his song. Everything's cool. I love my red shoes. 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 Oh no! Pete stepped in a large pile of blueberries. What color did that turn his shoes? Blue! Did Pete cry? Goodness, no. He kept walking along and singing his song. Awesome. I love my blue shoes. 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 Oh no, Pete stepped in a large puddle of mud. What color did that turn his shoes? Brown! Did Pete cry? Goodness, no. He kept walking along and singing his song, Groovy. I love my brown shoes. 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 Oh no, Pete stepped in a bucket of water. And all of the brown and all of the blue and all the red, all of it washed away. What color were his shoes again? White. But now they were wet. Did Pete cry? Goodness, no. He kept walking along singing his song, Rock and Roll. I love my wet shoes. 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 The moral of Pete's story is, no matter what you step in, keep walking along and singing your song. Because it's all good. I love my white shoes. 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 Love my white shoes. I love my white shoes. I love my white shoes. I love my white shoes. Thank you. So Pete's cool, right? That much we know. He endures. He loves his white shoes, but something happens. He didn't plan on the mud. He didn't plan on the strawberries. But it doesn't get to him, right? He's cool. I think that's the obvious interpretation, though. Right, the obvious interpretation is things don't go according to your plans. And don't take it too seriously and don't get too disappointed. Just be cool. And that's okay. But Pete's not just cool, right? He doesn't say, oh, my white shoe, I love my white shoes, but now that I walked in some strawberries, they're red, and I'll put a, I still love my white shoes because I know underneath they're really white, but I'll just ignore the fact that they're red. That's endurance, and it's important. But that's not what he says. When he steps in the strawberries, he doesn't say, I love my white shoes, and I'll ignore that they're red. He says, I love my red shoes. 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 See, Pete doesn't walk in the world with a lot of expectations. If his shoes are white, he loves his white shoes. If his shoes are red, he loves his red shoes. The way way he deals with the world isn't contingent on the details going on around him. He's not married to a particular picture of the world around him. He doesn't need his shoes to be a particular color, because he's not trying to force his own agenda onto the world around him. When he says that he loves his white shoes, he loves his brown shoes, he loves his wet shoes, what he's expressing is that his love and acceptance of the world is not contingent on those little details. He is already in love, not with the static world that he's used to, but with a dynamic world that's changing and isn't going according to any particular plan. Right? He's cool no matter what. let's practice. What Pete's doing isn't complicated, but it's important. It's easy. He's just in love with the world the way it is right now. The problem is, as cognitive creatures, we tend to get stuck in ideologies, basic ideas about the world and the way it should be, and then those ideas separate us from being in love with the world the way it is right now, in this moment, the whole thing. Or he's cutting it into pieces and saying this part's good and that part's bad. The irony is that that reality, this imperfection, if you will, this tendency to label things as bad, is itself part of the greater perfection. Like it or not, that's just how it is. Pete chooses to like it. So for a moment, take note of what you're observing. This video, things other than the video. Entertain the possibility that everything's okay. Love it the way it is right now. Is that a stretch? If it is, bring forth in your mind something that's easy to love. Maybe it's a person, maybe it's a value, situation, maybe it's chocolate cake. And allow yourself to fall in love with that. But remember, the form itself is just a placebo that we're using. It's just a tool, and we're going to let go of it. The main thing is that feeling. That feeling of real appreciation. Not endurance, not putting up with something. But enthusiastically loving something. Hold on to that feeling. Put your concentration on the feeling. And now, in that space, bring forth the physical world around you. Chair you're sitting in, the computer in front of you, or whatever. And extend this love to those things. Look at the things beyond that. Look at the people that you're going to have to deal with tomorrow. Some of them might be annoying. Send your love to them. Look at what you did today. Look at what you did yesterday. Your overall life. Extend your love to all of it. If you get lost, go back to the original feeling. Go back to the things that it's easy to go to be in love with. When you do this kind of exercise, sometimes the mental gymnastics and emotional gymnastics, you kind of get lost. And that's okay, just come back home. Find that love again. Not theoretical, real. Extend it beyond the world. Some people like to use visualizations, a golden light from your heart. That if you want. Or I like to play with things like little balls. There's a lot of snow outside. I use snowballs. Little love snowballs. What was the most annoying thing that happened to you in the last week? Take your love snowball and throw it to that. It doesn't mean it wasn't annoying. We're not saying that. I'm not changing the reality. We're loving the reality. You are annoyed. Fine. Love the whole situation. Accept the whole situation. Enthusiastically embrace the whole situation. Throw your snowballs to tomorrow. Throw your snowballs to next week. Put your life in a wider context. You're one of those little who's on a dust speck. And that dust speck is in a wider dust speck. And that dust speck is in a wider dust speck. The universe, possibly the multiverse, is unfathomably huge. And that's where you're at. You're gonna need a lot of snowballs. Love the whole thing. Love the whole past. Love the whole future. Radiate.